Blessed evening, my dear brothers and sisters. Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. And a blessed evening also sa mga kapatid natin na sumusubaybay online as you are doing your devotion there and we are celebrating the sacrament of the Eucharist here. Whatever grace that we are enjoying here should, sana, and hopefully will flow to your household. Today's gospel is set on Capernaum, my dear brothers and sisters. Capernaum was apparently close to the permanent place where Jesus Christ was doing his ministry. And on his way to Capernaum, he delivered the second prophecy of the Passion. Ano yun? That the Son of Man is to be delivered in the power of men. They will put him to death, and when he will be put to death, after 3 days, he will rise again. What was the reaction of the disciples? Yung unang reaction last week, nung diniklara ni Jesus Christ ang kanyang kahihinatnan sa Jerusalem, after Peter has delivered his profession of faith, sabi ni Peter, "You are the Son of God, the Messiah, the Anointed One." Pero nung sinabi niya na yung prophecy, sabi ni Peter sa kanya, "Lord, that shouldn't happen. God forbid." And in other part of the gospel, Peter said, "I will even lay my life for you. Hindi ko pa hihintulutan yan." That was the first reaction of the disciples. Hindi nagsisink in kung ano yung tinuturo ni Jesus sa kanila. And Jesus Christ rebuked Peter. Anong sabi? "Get behind me, Satan." Ang pag-iisip mo ay makamundo. Hindi yan ang paraan ng pag-iisip ng Diyos. And so, the second prophecy is today. The disciples didn't understand kung ano ang sinasabi ni Jesu Cristo. And the gospel said, they were afraid to ask. Ayaw nila magtanong. But at that moment, very curious, ano yung ginawa ng mga disipulo? They were arguing about who is the greatest among them? Sino ang pinakadakila sa kanila? And they failed to understand how Christ, the Anointed One, should suffer and die. They failed to understand also the role of being a disciple of our Lord. Ang kanilang iniisip lang, ano ang kanilang magiging ganansya sa pagsunod Yesu Cristo. They were thinking, what's in it for them? Ano ang para sa kanila? My dear brothers and sisters, when they reached Capernaum, Jesus Christ asked them, what were you arguing about? Ano yung pinagtatalunan nyo? And they were silent. And Jesus Christ declared there this, anyone who wants to be first must be the last of all and servant of all. Pag ginamit ang salitang servant sa Bible, very important yan, ginagamit sa salitang Grego ang word na diakonos. Or in English, we use the word deacon. Ano ba yung diakonos? Ang diakonos, my dear brothers and sisters, it indicates a menial worker. Yung kayang gumawa ng mga bagay na somehow insignificant. Maybe a slave or a waiter at the table, but the ideal diakono should be, though yun yung work niya, must have a trait of being a generous one. A true diakonos is self-forgetting. He is humble. He is gracious. He is attentive. He is watching and listening and ready to act when someone is in need of help. Laging handa na magsilbi. And then Jesus put a little child in the midst and saying, what is the significance of being a child? Of course, aside from the family affection na pwedeng ibigay ng bata, alam natin at that moment, very ironic yung ginawa ng ating Panginoong Jesucristo. Bakit? Children are not treated significantly in the ancient world. Wala silang bilang. Walang bilang yan. They have no social status or legal rights. They have no prestige whatsoever until they reach yung adulthood. That is the only time that they will become socially visible. But before that, pagbata ka, invisible ka. Kaya when Jesus Christ has placed a child in the midst of this disciple, ano yung gusto niya sabihin? Dalawang bagay. Una, discipleship in the Gospel of Matthew. When he placed the child, sinabi niya, this is how to be a disciple. You copy a child. Paano ba maging bata? Kaya nga, sabi niya, unless you change and become like children, copy the children. And if not, you will not enter the kingdom of God. The meaning is plain enough. To be follower of our Lord Jesus Christ, you must get rid pride. You must get rid any worldly standing that will impede you in entering the kingdom of God. I will give one example. Palagay ko napakinggan nyo to. This is a story oftentimes being told as an example. Alam nyo, it is happening every time na merong namamatay na isang dignitary sa Vienna, so Austria. There is one Franciscan church doon. So for 900 years, ito yung nakaugalian ng Habsburg dynasty. Ano yung nangyayari doon? Kapag merong namamatay na dignitary o nasa linya ng pamilya na yaon, ililibing siya sa subterranean crypt ng Franciscan church doon. And so, people are gathering outside the church, doing a procession towards the church. And when they will approach the church door, yung pintuan ng simbahan ay nakasarado. And then the imperial dignitary, the one representing everyone, will knock at the door. And he will seek for an admittance. Yung mga monks sa loob, mga Franciscan monks, will shout, sisigaw. Sasabi nila, who is it who seeks entrance? And then the dignitary outside will say, it is the Royal Highness, by the grace of God, Emperor of Austria and Hungary. You know, the monk would reply with this, we do not know him. Imagine, no? Nagpakilalang emperor, yung mga pari sa loob ng simbahan, sasabihin, we do not know him. And so there will be a second knock, kakatok na naman. And the dignitary will say, let us enter. Sasagot yung monk sa loob, who is it who seeks entrance? Ang sasagot ng dignitary ganito, His Serene Majesty, the King of Bohemia, Dalmatia, Croatia, Slovenia, Galicia, Protector of Jerusalem, and the list goes on. Sabi daw, 30 titles. Alam niyo kung anong sasagot ng monk sa loob? Sasagutin niya, I do not know him. Hindi ko siya kilala. And there will be a third knock. Kakatok na naman yung dignitary. Sasagot yung monk sa loob, who is it that desired entrance here? Ask the monk. And this time, the answer would be, a mortal, poor sinner, your brother is humbly requesting for an admittance. Sasabihin ng monk o ng pare, permission is granted. Enter, you sinner. You are known to us. Galing, no? Galing! Ako hangang-hanga ako doon. Bakit? The model of greatness, my dear brothers and sisters, the model of greatness in the kingdom of God is not when you place a lot of achievements in your shoulder. Hindi! Yung dami ng plaque mo, sa dami ng medalya mo, ang dami mo narating. No! The model of greatness for Jesus Christ is a powerless child. Yung walang sinabi, walang bilang, yung hindi napapansin, that is greatness. But today's gospel, from the Gospel of Mark and also connected to the Gospel of Luke, there is a slight different way when Jesus Christ has presented the child. Ang sabi niya naman, whoever welcomes a child. Kanina, to be like a child. Ngayon, whoever welcomes a child. These little children in my name welcomes me. Jesus defines true greatness not only being like a child, but a humble service to others. Yung pagtanggap doon sa mga taong walang sinabi. Most apparent, those people who are insignificant, exemplified by a child. True greatness, my dear brothers and sisters, consists of not holding great offices, but doing service to those people na walang bilang. Greatness in the kingdom of God overturns the usual perception of what greatness in the world, such as honor, such as name, label, achievement, success, baliktad. Sabi nga ni Cardinal Tagle sa kanyang Word Expose, parang 2015 niya sinabi ito, "To love the greatest is always connected to the love of the lowliest." Yung pag-ibig natin doon sa pinakadakila ay laging konektado sa pagmamahal natin sa pinakamaliit. At ang sabi ko naman, ang pagmamahal sa Diyos sa dakila ay laging nakaugnay sa paglilingkod at pagmamahal sa pinakamababa, mababa, lalo-lalo na sa mga bata. And I will end with one line coming from Jean Valjean of Les Miserables. Sabi niya, "To love another person is to see the face of God." Amen.